The disability is the capacity of a number to be divided by another number without a remainder. I hope you understand that. Divisible means you can divide a number without a remainder. Basta daw pwedeng i-divide nang walang remainder. Okay? Linawin pa natin. For example, divisible by 5 means you can divide a certain number by 5 without a remainder. Like 75, for example. 75 is divisible by 5. Divisible by 2 means you can divide a certain number by 2 without a remainder. Like 54, for example. 54 is divisible by 2. Divisible by 10 means you can divide a certain number by 10 without a remainder. Like 120, for example. 120 is divisible by 10. Yun ang ibig sabihin ng divisible. So ano naman yung not divisible? Now 75 is not divisible by 2. Because when you divide it by 2, you'll get a remainder 1. 54 is not divisible by 5. Because when you divide it by 5, you'll get a remainder 4. 54 is also not divisible by 10. Because when you divide it by 10, you'll also get a remainder 4. So kapag i-divide mo ang isang number, tapos may remainder, hindi ito divisible sa number na yon. Okay?
Good to know.
So tell me, is 45 divisible by 5? It is. Kasi 45 divided by 5 equals 9. At walang remainder. But is 45 divisible by 2? It is not. Kasi 45 divided by 2 equals 22, remainder 1.
Really?
What about 12,728? Is this divisible by 2? I know. 12,728 is a big number. You can divide it by 2 to check if it's divisible by 2, but it will take some time. Medyo matagal kapag i-divide natin. But there is a shorter way, a shortcut. To quickly check if a number is divisible by 2, just check if the number is even. If it is, then it is divisible by 2. Ano nga ba yung even numbers? Yung numbers na nagtatapos sa 0, 2, 4, 6, or 8. So, is 12,728 divisible by 2? It is. 12,728 ends in 8. 8 is an even number. So, 12,728 is divisible by 2.
Wow!
So, ito yung shortcut or rule para malaman natin if a number is divisible by 2. You can pause this video and copy this rule on your notebook. How about these numbers? Divisible din ba sila by 2? Is 56 divisible by 2? Yes! Nag-e-end siya sa 6, an even number. Is 124 divisible by 2? Yes! Nag-e-end siya sa 4, even number din. Is 400 divisible by 2? Yes! Even number din. Is 391 divisible by 2? No! Nag-e-end siya sa 1, an odd number. Now you try it. Answer with yes or no. If the number is divisible by 2, answer yes. If not, answer no. You can do this mentally, or you may write down your answers on your notebook. 5 seconds lang ibibigay ko, pero pwede nyong i-pause yung video kung kulang kayo sa oras. Ready? Begin. Are you finished?
No!
Let's check your answers. Is 500 divisible by 2? Yes, nag-e-end siya sa 0. Even number. Is 125 divisible by 2? No, nag-e-end siya sa 5. Odd number. Is 158 divisible by 2? Yes, nag-e-end siya sa 8. Is 75 divisible by 2? No, nag-e-end siya sa 5. Is 31 divisible by 2? No. Nag-e-end siya sa 1. Odd number. So, did you get everything correct? But that is only the rule for numbers divisible by 2. There are other rules for divisibility. Tingnan natin yung susunod. To quickly check if a number is divisible by 5, just check if the number ends in 0 or 5. That is easier, right? Iti-check lang natin if the number ends in 5 or 0. Let's see some examples. Is 35 divisible by 5? Yes, it is. It ends in 5. Is 100 divisible by 5? Yes, it is. It ends in 0. Is 500 divisible by 5? Yes, it is. It ends in 0. Is 256 divisible by 5? No, it's not. It doesn't end in 5 or 0. Is 99 divisible by 5? No, it's not. It doesn't end in 5 or 0. Now it's your turn. Kaya naman. Answer with yes or no. If the number is divisible by 5, answer yes. If not, answer no. You can do this mentally or sa notebook nyo. Post nyo na lang yung video kung kulang kayo sa oras. Ready? Begin. Are you finished?
What a naughty boy.
Let's check your answers. Is 500 divisible by 5? Yes. Nag-e-end siya sa 0. Is 125 divisible by 5? Yes. Nag-e-end siya sa 5. Is 158 divisible by 5? No. Is 73 divisible by 5? No. Is 310 divisible by 5? Yes. Nag-e-end siya sa 0. So, did you get everything correct?
Yes!
Now we go to the rule of numbers divisible by 10. To quickly check if a number is divisible by 10, just check if the number ends in 0. Mas madali ito. Let's see some examples. Is 100 divisible by 10? Yes, it is. Nag-e-end siya sa 0. Is 350 divisible by 10? Yes, it is. Is 500 divisible by 10? Yes, it is. Is 225 divisible by 10? No, it's not. Nag-e-end siya sa 5. Is 101 divisible by 10? No, it's not. Nag-e-end siya sa 1. Now, let's see if you understand. Answer with yes or no.
Wait a minute!
If the number is divisible by 10, answer yes. If not, answer no. Again, you can do this mentally or sa notebook nyo. Post nyo na lang yung video kung kulang kayo sa oras. Ready? Begin. Are you finished?
Of course!
Let's check your answers. Is 400 divisible by 10? Yes. Is 125 divisible by 10? No. Is 150 divisible by 10? Yes. Is 75 divisible by 10? No. Is 310 divisible by 10? Yes. So, did you get everything correct?
Yes!
Now here's a tip. A number that is divisible by 10 is also divisible by both 5 and 2. Kapag divisible daw by 10, divisible din yun sa 5 tsaka sa 2. Like 20 for example. 20 is divisible by 10 because it ends in 0. It is also divisible by 5 because it ends in 0. Remember the rule? 0 or 5? It is also divisible by 2 because it is an even number. It is ending in 0. Just remember the rules, okay? Now what about 125? Is this divisible by 2, 5, and 10? 125 is not divisible by 10 because it does not end in 0. 125 is also not divisible by 2 because it is not an even number. But 125 is divisible by 5 because it ends in 5. If you don't remember the rules, that's okay. You just divide.
Wow.
To To check if a number is divisible by 3, you must add the digits. If the sum of the digits is divisible by 3, or is in the multiplication table of 3, then the number is divisible by 3. Let's see some examples. Is 135 divisible by 3? Anong gagawin natin? We add the digits. 1 plus 3 plus 5 equals 9. 9 is in the multiplication table of 3, so 135 is divisible by 3. Mas madaling isipin kung divisible by 3 yung 9 kaysa sa 135, di ba?
I'm Groot.
Anyway, another example. Is 216 divisible by 3? Again, we add the digits. 2 plus 1 plus 6 equals 9. 9 is in the multiplication table of 3. So, 216 is divisible by 3. Madali lang, di ba? Isa pang example. Is 1,725 divisible by 3? Huwag matakot sa malaking number. We just add the digits. 1 plus 7 plus 2 plus 5 equals 15. 15 is in the multiplication table of 3. So, 1,725 is divisible by 3.
Wow!
You can rewind the video and copy the examples if you want. Of course, it is good to have a list of rules and examples so you can find them when you need them. Now, let's see if you understand. If the number is divisible by 3, answer yes. If not, answer no.
No!
You can do this mentally, or you may write down your answers on your notebook. Begin. Are you finished? Let's check your answers. Is 102 divisible by 3? Let's add the digits. 1 plus 0 plus 2 equals 3. Yes, 3 is in the multiplication table of 3, so 102 is divisible by 3. Number 2. Is 75 divisible by 3? Let's add the digits. 7 plus 5 equals 12. 12 is in the multiplication table of 3, so 75 is divisible by 3. Number 3. Is 218 divisible by 3? Let's add the digits. 2 plus 1 plus 8 equals 11. 11 is not in the multiplication table of 3, so 218 is not divisible by 3. Number 4. Is 343 divisible by 3? Let's add the digits. 3 plus 4 plus 3 equals 10. 10 is not in the multiplication table of 3, so 343 is not divisible by 3. Number 5. Is 3528 divisible by 3? Let's add the digits. 3 plus 5 plus 2 plus 8 equals 18. 18 is in the multiplication table of 3. So yes, 3525 is divisible by 3. Did you get everything correct? I hope so. Okay, let's go to the next rule. To check if a number is divisible by 9, you also add the digits. If the sum of the digits is divisible by 9, then the number is divisible by 9. Kapareho lang yan ang divisible by 3. Let's see some examples. Is 135 divisible by 9? Anong gagawin natin? We add the digits. 1 plus 3 plus 5 equals 9. 9 is in the multiplication table of 9. So, 135 is divisible by 9. Di ba mas madali yun kaysa mag-divide tayo by 9?
I'm Groot.
Another example. Is 396 divisible by 9? Again, we add the digits. 3 plus 9 plus 6 equals 18. 18 is in the multiplication table of 9. So, 396 is divisible by 9. Kailangan lang kabisado nyo yung multiplication table of 9. Kung hindi, you need a table beside you.
That's a no.
You can copy the examples if you want, para may kopya kayo na pwedeng tingnan later. Now, let's see if you understand.
I'm Groot.
If the number is divisible by 9, answer yes. If not, answer no. You can do this mentally, or you may write down your answers on your notebook.
Bigo, bigo.
Begin. Are you finished? Let's check your answers. Number 1 is 108 divisible by 9. We add the digits. 1 plus 0 plus 8 equals 9. Yes, 108 is divisible by 9. Number 2 is 299 divisible by 9. Let's add the digits. 2 plus 9 plus 9 equals 20. 20 is not in the multiplication table of 9. So the answer is no. Number 3 is 450 divisible by 9. Let's add the digits. 4 plus 5 plus 0 equals 9. 9 is in the multiplication table of 9, so the answer is yes. Number 4 is 341 divisible by 9. Let's add the digits. 3 plus 4 plus 1 equals 8. 8 is not in the multiplication table of 9, so the answer is no. Number 5 is 3888 divisible by 9. Let's add 3 plus 8 plus 8 plus 8 equals 27. 27 is in the multiplication table of 9, so the answer is yes. Did you get everything correct?
Of course!
Okay, let's go to the next rule. To check if a number is divisible by 6, you check if the number is divisible by 2 and 3. Ano nga ba yung rules para sa divisible by 2 tsaka divisible by 3? To check if a number is divisible by 2, just check if the number is an even number. To check if a number is divisible by 3, you add the digits. If the sum of the digits is divisible by 3, then the number is divisible by 3. Let's see some examples. Is 96 divisible by 6? Anong gagawin natin? We check if it is divisible by 2. Is 96 an even number? Yes. Then it is divisible by 2. Then we check if it is divisible by 3. We add the digits. 9 plus 6 equals 15. 15 is in the multiplication table of 3. So, 96 is divisible by 3. And if 96 is divisible by both 2 and 3, then it is divisible by 6. If you find these rules long or hard, edi mag-divide ka na lang by 6. Another example. Is 398 divisible by 6? Is it divisible by 2? Is it even? Yes! So it is divisible by 2. Is it divisible by 3? We add the digits. 3 plus 9 plus 8 equals 20. 20 is not divisible by 3. So, 396 is not divisible by 6. Basta hindi divisible by 2 or 3, kahit sa isa lang sa kanila, then hindi yun divisible by 6.
I'm Groot.
Another example. Is 275 divisible by 6? Is it divisible by 2? Is it even? No. Therefore, 275 is not divisible by 6. Kapag add, no agad. Ganun kabilis yun, okay? Now it's your turn. Kaya naman. If the number is divisible by 6, answer yes. If not, answer no. Again, you can do this mentally. Or you may write down your answers on your notebook. Begin. Are you finished? Let's check your answers. Is 78 divisible by 6? Let's check if 78 is divisible by 2. Is it even? Yes, it is. Let's check if it is divisible by 3. We add the digits. 7 plus 8 equals 15. 15 is divisible by 3. So, 78 is divisible by 6. And the answer is yes. Number 2. Is 128 divisible by 6? Is it divisible by 2? It is even, so it is divisible by 2. Is it divisible by 3? Let's add the digits. 1 plus 2 plus 8 equals 11. 11 is not divisible by 3, so the answer is no. Number 3. Is 256 divisible by 6? Is it divisible by 2? Is it even? Yes, it is. Is it divisible by 3? Let's add the digits. 2 plus 5 plus 6 equals 13. 13 is not divisible by 3, so the answer is no. Number 4. Is 141 divisible by 6? 141 is an odd number, so the answer is no. Kapag add, no agad. Number 5. Is 2,586 divisible by 6? Is it even? Or is it divisible by 2? It is even, so it is divisible by 2. Is it divisible by 3? That's other digits. 2 plus 5 plus 8 plus 6 equals 21. 21 is divisible by 3, so the answer is yes. Did you get everything correct? I think that's enough for the first part of our lessons on divisibility. If you didn't understand any part of the lesson, you can replay the video and watch it again. Just listen very well. Observe the examples, kung paano sila isolve. Also, observe kung paano isinolve yung mga answers sa exercises. Of course, I would really suggest that you copy all the rules, tips, and examples on your notebook para may collection kayo na pwede nyo tingnan anytime. And after this, you can proceed to working on your modules. A copy of my lessons can be found in your Google Classroom, including all rules, tips, examples, exercises, and answers to exercises. There is also a short quiz in your Google Classroom that you must answer. Practice lang naman para hindi nyo malimutan yung lessons. If you have problems working on your modules, or if you have problems on the lesson itself, you can ask your teacher during your time of discussion. We will continue our lessons on divisibility on the next video. So, see you around!